Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install WordPress in your localhost and how to use entire features of WordPress at your localhost, and that is absolutely free. So let's begin. Now to install WordPress, you need to first install a server first. So what I'm going to show you a server called Xampp. So using our Xampp server, we are going to install WordPress. So before that, you need to first install Xampp. So go to your favorite browser, and in here just simply type Xampp download, then enter, and then you'll be seeing this www.apachefriends.org is really our first search result. So now just simply click on this download Xampp, and this will automatically going to redirect you to this official site of Xampp. So here you can clearly see this Xampp version is 8.0.6, is basically the latest version. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to simply click on this download 64-bit option, and this will automatically going to start downloading our Xampp. I have already downloaded it, so just simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see this Xampp 8.0.7 has been rightly downloaded over here. Now to install Xampp, just simply double click on it, and this will going to ask you administrative privileges. So for that, just simply click on yes to provide administrative privileges, and let us first minimize our download directory, and you can clearly see our Xampp setup has been rightly opened. So in here, just simply click on next. Then these are the files that going to be installed, so keep this all default, then simply click on next. So this is going to be your installation folder, so keep this all default, then simply click on next. The default language is English. If you want to change it to Dutch, then you can always do that, but I'm going to keep this English, then next. So then again the setup is completed, so just simply click on next. This will automatically going to open this browser. So for the time being, just simply minimize it, and it's now currently telling that ready to be installed. So just again simply click on next for installation, and you can clearly see our installation has been rightly started. So let us first again go to our browser and see what it is showing us. So it's telling that share hello to your favorite application Xampp. Okay, hello Xampp. And if you just simply scroll down a bit, you can clearly see this WordPress, right? So this WordPress, Joomla, Drupal, all those things are absolutely free. You can use using Xampp. I'm going to right now show you how to download and install WordPress at your local host. So for that, what we need to do is we need to just simply open a new tab, and in here just simply type wordpress.org. Yeah, then enter. I'll be also putting the link in the description, so you don't have to worry about the link and all. So you can clearly see this official site of wordpress.org has been rightly opened. So in here, just simply click on this get WordPress, and this will automatically going to open this get WordPress site. So in here, if you just scroll down a bit, you'll be getting this download WordPress 5.7.2. yeah, so just simply click on that for installing about WordPress. So it has rightly started downloading WordPress 5.7.2. just simply cancel it because I have already downloaded it. So just simply minimize it, and let us see how much the installation has been done. So it's now currently about 20%. So just keep this there, and then go back to our download directory, and here you can clearly see our WordPress 5.7.2 has been rightly downloaded over here. So what we need to do is you need to just simply right click on it, then simply click on extract all. Yeah, and this is going to be the folder name WordPress 5.7.2. so just simply keep this all default, then extract. Yeah, and this will going to start extracting our WordPress, and currently it's now running, and it will take about 4 minutes to complete the task. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back after extraction of WordPress 5.7.2. yeah, so welcome back, and now you can clearly see our WordPress folder has been rightly extracted over here. Then right click on it, and then copy, right, and then just simply minimize it and see whether the Xampp has been properly installed or not. So you can clearly see our Xampp has been, you know, also installed. So just, you know, simply click on finish, and then just, you know, simply start our Apache, and then also start our MySQL. Yeah, and then it's telling that this Windows Defender has blocked some of the features, so you know we need to just simply check this and then just simply click on allow access, so that you know it just give access of the folder. So you know, just you can clearly see these two item has been, you know, rightly started. So just, you know, simply minimize it, then again go to your Windows Explorer. You have rightly copied this WordPress, again copy, then go to your C drive, then Xampp, then htdocs. This is very important, you know, to save this file inside your htdocs. All right, so just, you know, simply go inside that folder, then right click on it, then paste. So what we are basically doing is we are just, you know, simply first extracting our WordPress file from the WordPress zip that we have downloaded, and also we have installed Xampp to, you know, create our local host environment, right? So, and after that, after extracting, we are just, you know, simply going to paste that WordPress inside our local disk C, Xampp, and then localhost folder, right? So it has, you know, rightly copied over here. This WordPress has been, you know, rightly copied over here. So just, you know, simply cancel it. It is now for no use. You need to just again go to your Xampp control panel, and in here, just, you know, simply click on this admin. And this will, you know, automatically going to open this localhost PHP admin in here into create a new database. So for that, just, you know, simply click on new. Yeah. And then give a database name. So let's give a database name as WordPress. So WordPress, basically, you know, the name of our database, then create. Yeah. And then you can clearly see our WordPress database has been, you know, rightly created over here. So just again open a new tab and type localhost, then slash, and that, and then the name of our folder is WordPress, right? Then enter. So just, you know, simply type localhost slash WordPress. So this WordPress is actually coming from the htdoc folder that is, you know, we have just copied over here. So this htdoc, so this WordPress is basically, you know, the name that we are basically typing over here, WordPress. And this will, you know, automatically going to open this page. So just, you know, simply select a language as per your wish. I'm going to, you know, click on English and then continue. Yeah, so this will, you know, going to state you welcome to WordPress, and before starting we need to set some, you know, name, username, password and host. I'm going to, you know, show you that, so you don't need to worry about that. So for the time being, just, you know, simply click on let's go, and then in here you need to provide your database name. So the database name you have given over here is WordPress, right? So, you know, just simply give that same database name WordPress. So nothing need to modify it, because we have, you know, given this same name WordPress. And then inside this username you need to provide the username as root. This is very important. By default, the username is root and the password is blank. So this is only in localhost, so you don't need to worry about the password and all. So username is root, password is blank, and then keep other thing default, then simply click on submit. Yeah, and now it's telling that it is, you know, ready to be installed. So just, you know, simply click on run the installation to begin our installation. And before that, you need to provide a site title name. So let's give a site title name as Geeky Script. It totally depend upon you what name you are going to type. So I'm going to, you know, simply type Geeky Script as our site title name, and then inside the username I'm going to, you know, simply type root as a username, and the password I'm going to, you know, simply type admin. I know this is a weak password, but I am going to only use this PC, so it's not a problem. You need to confirm this use of a weak password, so, you know, just simply check that, and then, you know, you need to provide an email address. So let's give your email address. So I am giving my email address, so geekyscript@outlook.com, and then just simply click on install WordPress. So this will going to start installing WordPress, and it's now rightly installed. So you can clearly see this WordPress has been installed. It's now currently telling that save password or not. I don't want to save this password. So just simply click on login to login your WordPress account. So remember, you have set your username as a root and the password is admin, right? So just simply write that, then simply check this remember me, and then simply click on login to login your account. And then you'll be seeing this dashboard of our WordPress, right? So this is basically the dashboard of our WordPress. You can easily view your site over here. So just simply click on this view visit site and you'll be getting this site. You can easily go back to your dashboard by simply clicking on this dashboard over here, and this is basically your dashboard. You can easily import theme. So for that, just simply click on appearance, then theme, and in here this is basically the theme. If you want to add a new theme, then you need to just simply click on this add new, and then these are the themes that are available. So you can download any of the theme that you want to use, and you'll be getting that theme, and then you can modify as per your requirements. Yeah, so in my next video I'm going to show you that. So for that, you need to just simply put a comment in our comment section and just need to tell me that whether you require such videos. So that's basically all about this video. I have rightly shown you how to install WordPress in your local host and how to use WordPress for absolutely free. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.